What's up, YouTube? This is Easy Logic here. Yo, so right now I got myself the virtual pack Amiibos. Basically comes with what you see here, which is Duck Hunt, Rob the Robot, and Game Watch. And Game Watch actually comes with four sets. So you got the set that you see here, because a parachute, his bell attack, and Nine Hammer. And they're all actually labeled on the bottom here, on the floor. It's actually a very good display box. So like, even if you don't want to keep this on your shelf, it's actually really cool to do that for you. So anyway, I'm gonna open this up. I'm gonna see how to put this baby together, right? So I really want to preserve the back here because I actually never bought a 3-pack before. The only other 3-pack that's gonna come out in America right now is the 3-pack, I believe, Mii Fighters, which it comes in Sword Fighter, Gunner, and Brawl. But if you go to right now, the 3-pack of the virtual pack is what it's dubbed as. It's actually not available anywhere else but Europe and America. So Japan actually has to wait a couple more weeks until it comes out. I have no idea why that's the case. I guess they're trying to prevent import sales into America or something. Because Nintendo themselves have been trying really hard to push the stock back up. So, let's see. Almost got this here. Ah, there we go. So they're really trying to come back with this stock. And they are doing a whole bunch of restocks of Lil Max and Toys R Us. They're doing restocks pretty much anywhere America sells in most retailers, but Japan, for some weird reason, are going second, so that's a weird thing. Also, this is the only reason why this is also very valuable in Japan is because in America, when America first came out with the Super Nintendo, or the Nintendo console, excuse me, it actually came in two different colors, which was this color, which is the American one, which is white and gray, which was basically the American version, whereas the Famicom version, or okay, the Japanese version, came out in red and gray. So there's actually two different sets of Rob the Robot. So for collectors, you won't actually be able to complete your set unless you actually import. So keep up on that and wait until the Japanese release one comes out. And luckily, they come in single packs and not the 3-pack like we got. So it's very valuable right now. So I got the thing out and hooked all together. Very nice. And I already see a problem that's bothering me. On the back of Duncan's head, I'm not sure if you can see it properly, but there's a little smudge there, but that's no big deal. I can fix that myself, so. It's actually really nice, actually. I like the design is really well done. The placement, this is nice. Like, if you want to put this as just a stand set, this is a very, very nice set. You can just stand on your shelf like that. And you got all the Game Watch pieces sitting on the bottom, but unfortunately for me, I'm going to even open that up, so. Let's start with Duck Hunt, since he already has a flaw that I can see. Ah, Game Watch fell off. Cool. I've been seeing them use this a lot. They now use this like this little paper magnetic strip instead of the little plastic strip. I don't know why they've been doing that, but that's new. So, Duck Hunt's not that bad. It's really the one that done well. Like I said, there's a little thing on the back of the head that I'm not really a big fan of, but cool. I don't know. It'll be fine. I'm overthinking it, but it's a nice design. It's one solid piece, so there's not too many pieces that will fly off. Probably the wings, maybe, but the dog is actually pretty good one piece, so that's nice by itself. For giggles, let's do Rob first. Let's do Rob after this. So Rob, okay, this motherfucker looks like he can break. No, I'm lying. Actually, he's pretty sturdy. Actually, I wouldn't twist him so much, but yeah, this one solid piece, nice. You see the dark gray on gray color is really nice. Did the eyes very well. You can actually see the inside the color. So this is actually very well done. And on the back, you can see that as an on and off switch for basically when you was actually using Rob the Robot back in the day for a Nintendo Entertainment System. So that's pretty nice. And Game & Watch. Game & Watch just so, I think Game & Watch preceded Mario by at least a year maybe or something. I don't know, I think they both came out at the same time, but as you can see, it only goes in one way because the notch has a 1 and 2 symbol, so it only goes in this way. So, there's other figurines on the bottom here, which is, I think it has a little track here, which is nice. I would suggest anybody keeping this, so you can probably have it as a stand like that while you have them like this. I actually know a guy who bought 4 of these, which probably cost $120. Just so he can have a stand for all of them. That guy's a little bit crazy, but props to him. That guy's swag is fucking strong. So, yeah, let's get these out. Actually, I like Ninehammer. Ninehammer's pretty fucking cool. And Bell. Bell, I don't know what the fuck they put this here. Whatever. Parachute's pretty cool, but I like him. I'm definitely putting on Ninehammer. He's getting the Ninehammer treatment. There we go. Fucking crit. Alright, so overall, this is a. It's pretty solid, actually. Nice setup, everything's solid. Game Watch pieces are a little. Are very, very hard, very strong. Not gonna break easily, not gonna snap in half. And I could probably put them back here if I ever want them. So let me just put back the original figure so I can at least play back. That sticks in pretty well, actually, so that's pretty good. You'll probably want to worry about it falling off. So basically, this is the second to last 3-pack. After this is going to be Wave 6, which consists of Mewtwo, Ryu, the Mii Fighters, and Roy. And that little bastard, I forget his name, I think. Lucas. So, we only got like about 6 or 7 more amiibos left, guys, and the whole Smash Bros. Set will be complete. So far, these are my latest ones, and I'm happy with this. You can still actually order the Mii Fighters, which are actually out in Japan, from import for around maybe $30, I guess. But the other one you need to look for is also Modern Mario. Right now, today is what's today's date? The 28th. Today's the 28th, so Modern Mario should be coming out to 29th, excuse me. Today's the 29th, so Modern Mario should be coming out to the Americas in a single pack instead of the Wii U bundle exclusive around the 7th of October. So look out for that. Everything will be fine, alright? So, this is Easy Logic. I'm out. You take care, guys.